I don't think we have seen the worst yet. It is going to get worse before it starts getting better. We hope that it would gradually start getting better during 2022. But as I said, there are uncertainties. The semiconductor industry is investing a lot, but there are long lead times. When we get to 23 and then 24, most likely there will be much more capacity available. But 22 will be the key question here, that how this balance will play out.
Let's talk about 5G and where you think we are in the 5G cycle. How would you describe momentum at the moment in the 5G market?
5G market momentum is accelerating. We have increased our product competitiveness a lot, and a testimony to that is the 220 basis points improvement in our gross margin. But also the demand side is developing. Well, the European investments have starting to increase. Europe has been a little bit behind the United States and Korea and Japan and China in 5G. So that's what we are seeing. And then the next big thing will be industrial investment in 5G and next generation connectivity. There are 15 million industrial campuses of this in this world. And one way or another, we believe that the majority of them will invest in new generation communications networks in the coming years.
What are you doing to strengthen your position with 5G to ensure that you're able to capture some of that new demand?
Well, first of all, we have increased our development R&D resources by 40% in the last 2 years. And we have increased even more in chipset design. And we have, in relative terms, improved and strengthened our technology position a lot. We had major product launches in the second quarter, new generation of base stations, excellent feedback from customers, a lot of traction, and we have also won some new customers thanks to that new product platform.
Well, the competition in the 5G space is clearly heated. I'm curious what you're doing specifically to close the gap between yourselves and Ericsson, especially as the West pulls away from using Huawei in its rollout.
We are clearly demonstrating that we are closing the gap. And we said earlier that we believe that we will have closed the gap by the end of this year. And that's exactly what's happening. As I said, we have increased development resources a lot. We are getting good customer feedback. And we are now clearly turning the market share trend also when we look at the new contracts that we've been able to sign recently. Of course, catching up is one thing. After that, you need to go for leadership.
And when it comes to leadership, what's the kind of timeline that you're thinking of?
Well, there will be some new interesting inflection points in the market, which will enable new use cases, for example, for industrial use. And one natural point will be 2023, when the so-called 5G Advanced will start hitting the market, the standard release 18, some people call it. So far, for the last 2 years, we have been playing catch-up. That has been working very well. We have increased resources, and the next target is to take the lead.